Okay, it's time to watch the penultimate episode of Strange New Worlds Season 1. If we're going to judge this by a sort of pattern that's been developing, since the last episode was a bit more lackadaisical and just sort of fun, this episode's going to be pretty dark and intense. So I'm expecting that. Let's see if it's going to happen. So last episode we got our Iron Bang episode. I don't know who this is going to focus on, but there's no point in theorizing. I'll just shut up now and get into it.
My assignment to Enterprise is over. After we complete our current mission, delivering Vidium power cells to Deep Space Station K7,
I go back. Oh, K7.
I've rotated through almost every department. So many amazing, talented people. The top everyone of everything. I guess I'm still searching.
Time to bend some ears.
Enterprise is your home, Uhura. Get used to it.
Effective immediately, you are no longer an ensign. Congratulations, Lieutenant Duke.
I hate goodbyes.
Still haven't decided to stay.
She will.
There will always be a place on Enterprise for Neo to Uhura.
Spock, Captain Park. Oh. Incoming Priority 1 mission from Starfleet Command, sir. Spock out.
Aren't we already a Priority 1 mission?
Yeah.
Approximately 4 days ago, the USS Peregrine activated a distress beacon before losing contact.
USS Peregrine.
You're going to want to try the omelet and the bacon.
And the waffle.
The Peregrine's deep space relay took 2 days.
Can't turn down Pike's amazing food.
Oh my god, this is delicious.
Told you.
At the time of transmission, the Peregrine was making
I want to try Pike's cooking.
Landing on a class L planet.
A Sombra class ship. That's unique.
I served on one. Fast.
Sombra class.
Both of the same parts as a constitution.
I advise we send a landing party to make repairs and treat the wounded. Meanwhile, Enterprise can continue on to deliver the Vidium.
It's risky. There's no way the landing party could contact the ship.
True. It is a communications dead zone. But I have...
Nah, this is not looking good.
Us?
I'll oversee this one personally. Get the cadets out on one last away mission with senior officers.
You sure you want to split up the crew?
It'll be fine, number one. I'll pile the kids in the station wagon, take a road trip.
Sir?
Station wagon. Get the... It looks exactly like a Constitution class.
We'll monitor your approach.
Oh, this is sick.
Once we enter the upper atmosphere, we're going to be out of contact after...
It's literally a Constitution class. Why did they even bother calling it something else?
...to be overrun by an ice storm in approximately 6 hours.
This wind reminds me of Andoria.
Glad someone can enjoy it.
Captain, might not be a scanning problem.
Oh, it's a severed arm. Lovely.
Blood.
The bridge is completely offline. Someone hardwired all the controls down to engineering.
Hem, can you fix it?
Perhaps. I'll have to work in engineering.
Hem. That's nice.
20 casualties so far, one of them the captain.
Most died of hypothermia. Their suits are shredded by the elements.
Some of them were picked apart, maybe. Local wildlife?
Bet it's real creepy here after dark.
It's already pretty damn creepy.
Not that Sam Kirk's actually getting something to do for once.
What the hell did this?
Someone tells me it's not local wildlife.
Captain's log, Stardate. I'm not even sure. A week since we've crashed is when we found 3 castaways on an M-class planet. A human girl, a humanoid of unknown origin, and an Orion named Pasco. Pasco was infected with Gorn eggs. Biofilters didn't detect them, but the Orion...
Uh-oh. Gorn are back.
Could reach Starfleet now, I would say stay away. Don't come to Vallejo Beta 5.
Human or Gorn?
One human, the other unknown.
His body's been badly mangled.
Nice. Not very surprising considering what we saw the Gorn do in episode 4.
I heard you something.
That's not how linguistics works.
That is a really cool looking alien.
He might be protecting someone. We should lower our weapons.
Very smart of her.
We're friends.
Man, he's so cool looking. He's got the moving nose and stuff.
When you asked me about my life path, I didn't have an answer.
And you feel that serving in Starfleet is coasting?
I don't know. Maybe.
I really like how Hammer has developed in this. He's lost his edge a little bit, so he's not quite so gruff. He's much more friendly.
You think I don't like making friends?
No. I think you love it. Deep down, that scares you. You create bonds. It's a gift. Of course, the people you care about are going to cause you pain. It will hurt, but the love it yields will far outweigh the sorrow.
What's his name?
I call him Buckley.
I like it.
It's just what I call
Buckley.
What's your name?
Miranda. Are we getting out of here?
Readings don't show any anomalies.
No eggs.
Are you infected? Is he?
Oh, no. Stop harassing my daughter.
Well, they... What?
The girl and the two aliens were probably refugees from a breeding planet. The adult Gorn only harvests their young sporadically, so whatever was born on this ship, they are most likely alone.
Are we going to finally see them? I'm interested to see what they look like. I hope we do see them. Those sideburns or something else. Sounds like Jaws theme. Uh-oh. Buckley. Oh gosh, he's definitely infected.
Hello. Ugh. What is this now?
Pass me that light.
Yep.
Shouldn't you be a little more concerned? Ugh. Dang, he looks so cool. Now I feel so freaking bad for him.
Just gonna run a quick simulation on your scans.
This is bad. This is really, really bad. Really, really, really bad. She knows what's going on. Dang, this is so sad. I don't even... He just looks so sad. Wow, they literally are just xenomorphs. Oh, they are literally just xenomorphs. Wow. Ugh. Oh, what? They have like predator vision. Oh. First mission as a lieutenant, he freaking dies. Careful, Christine. Where could she have possibly gone?
4 Gorn hatchlings. I count 1 dead, that leaves 3. This is where she was before.
Dang, I wish Buckley lasted a little bit longer than that. Longer than 2 minutes.
And we're here to keep you safe. She's already safe. Gorn hate the cold. My brother died like your friend. The Gorn got him. I know what it feels like to watch them hurt the people you love. Trust me, there's surviving, and then there's living.
That's what Pike said to her in the first episode.
Just have to reboot navigation.
Team Hemora strikes again, huh?
Hemora.
I have the honor.
Uh-oh. Bad news.
I don't know.
It is not safe to leave the ship.
It isn't safe inside the ship. But hey, at least we'll all die nice and warm.
I could give him a sedative.
No, Sam's tougher than he looks. And I need everyone alert.
Regroup and rendezvous in sick bay. Repeat, get to sick bay and watch your six.
So that's what they look like. Anyway, well, they look much better than they did in Enterprise. Oh shit, Hemmer.
The Gorn's biological makeup renders them invisible to all of our sensors.
Of course it does.
These ducts in the mouth likely expel venom.
Yes, and it burns quite tremendously.
No doubt he talks him into blind its victims.
I was not the best target. Hemmer, I know you have rules. It appears they have a psychic barrier to my abilities.
Man, these Gorn are so overpowered.
Killed Duke right in front of you. Spock, doesn't that hit you somewhere deep inside? No, nothing.
We just need to reboot navigation.
He sounds like Chris Pine's Kirk.
Pointy-eared computer.
Hey!
The hatchlings have begun molting, but they aren't fully mature. At this stage, younglings have an intense drive for alpha dominance.
We can work together. That's our advantage.
No matter what, we have to kill them now. We'd have no chance even against one adult Gorn.
How are we supposed to hunt them? We can't even track them with sensors.
We make them come to us. Gorn avoid the cold. We can force them into the areas we want them in.
Now this sounds like the start of a plan. All right?
See, Pike can be a bit more heroic here because he knows he's not going to die. Oh, it's all blue, and the console is blue. Oh, that's cool.
If it succeeds, you and I will be trapped in here with angry Gorn. I will not be the one to kill it, but I will do what I must to protect the lives of this crew.
It's here.
You can hear a little bit of the TOS phaser sound effect when they shoot. It's cool. On a horse.
Blasting the transporter room now.
It's going into the vent system. Spock, get into position.
Oh, that's the thing that Buckley had.
It's not responding.
You have to draw it out.
Fight it, Spock. Make it angry.
Rage that is in my thoughts. I let into my heart.
Oh yeah, get it. Get it, Spock, get it.
The other one is here. It's boxing him in.
Spock, watch for the second Gorn.
They've turned on each other.
Good, that makes your lives a little bit easier than if they fight each other. They did look cool though. Very reminiscent of the original design. Oh, go, go, go. Is that all of them now? But Hemmer's still infected.
Going to go outside now.
The spray is more than a venom. It's how they reproduce.
Neutralize the growth process. Figure something out.
If we had more time, I'm sure you could. but it's too late. My sacrifice saved the lives of those I care most about. For me, there is no other choice.
The illogical conclusion.
Hammer's gonna frickin' die?
Live long and prosper, my friend.
You have to let us try!
Uhura. Make a home for yourself amongst others, and you will find joy more often than sadness. Do not weep for me. I've had a good life.
Hammer's dead. It looks exactly like the Enterprise. Give me a break that it's a different class.
I hate funerals. But if Hammer was here, he...
Oh, he looks so happy.
This is a celebration.
Oh, his hair. His hair is like combed and everything. Fallen
and commit them to the cosmos.
Always pushing me to see things from a new perspective. Do better. Be better. That's what Hammer's purpose was. To fix what is broken.
Spock's having some emotional problems.
I'm warning you, back off!
Bonfire.
I let something out. Rage. Pain.
It's your emotions. It doesn't make you weak, Spock. It makes you human.
She wants to kiss him so bad.
I found a lead on Oriana's family. I'd like to request a formal leave of absence. Decommission me if you have to, but I need the freedom to go where the clues take me.
However long it takes. Come back to us, okay?
All right, sir.
So she's going to be gone for... Well, there's only one episode left. I guess she's going to be gone for a little bit of season two, too. Two as well.
Chris. Thank you. For everything.
Stay, Uhura. Decide you're going to stay. I know you want to. I know you will. Okay, well, that's the second class episode of season one done. One episode left. Man, I was freaking sad. I certainly didn't expect Hammer to die or any main character to die. And, man, I feel like he was absent for a lot of the show, but I did feel impacted when he died. I mean, Bruce Horak gave a great performance, and he definitely had a nice arc. You know, he was very standoffish and had a really sharp edge to him in the beginning, and then he opened up really because of Uhura, and I think they had a really cool relationship. And, you know, it's sad that he's gone, and he was a really cool character. I loved everything about him, his sassiness and the fact that he was ENR, and it was just really cool. But interesting to see who's going to be chief engineer in the next season. Maybe Scotty? I don't know. But it's sad that he's gone, I will say that. The episode as a whole, though, not a ton of story. It's really more just sort of, showing off the Gorn. And I have some interesting things to talk about with the Gorn, because their new design is cool. However, the fact that they're like these primal insectoid, like, so seemingly like lower evolution beings, but yet they have super advanced space travel and these crazy ships, and they're super smart, and they're like highly evolved, and there's all these crazy things. It's a little bit hard to swallow, because we see when they're born, they kill each other, and they're vicious and primal, like I said. So it is hard for me to believe that they can be these brilliant spacefaring creatures if they act like that. But it's whatever. But the fact that, I mean, they literally are, they pulled straight from Alien. I mean, they look exactly like Xenomorphs when they're born. It was crazy. And I just realized, what was the little girl's name? She's literally Newt from Aliens, like exactly. and the little arms like Ripley. They do, and wow, and they pulled from Predator. Okay, so perhaps the originality of this episode wasn't so great, but it was still entertaining. We saw more of Sam Kirk, finally. I mean, he's been pretty much a nothing character this whole show. We saw that he's quite a bit like his brother, really. He reminded me a lot of Chris Pine's Kirk from the Kelvin timeline. And we saw the most interesting thing, I think, that was set up was Spock. Like, he's sort of broken his emotional barrier now, and now he's having a hard time controlling his emotion and rage. So I'm very interested to see where that goes. I thought maybe it's a sort of Pon-Farr thing they're going to do, but it's not like he hasn't been spending time with T'Pring, so I don't know what that's going to be about. But I'm talking about, you know, theorizing the future, because not too much happened this episode, really, besides the death of Hemmer and a few character points. It was, we saw a new ship, or a new ship. I mean, it looked exactly like the Enterprise, and it looked exactly like Constitution class, but it was something else. The USS Peregrine, what it was called, and I can't remember what the class was, but it was a Constitution. I mean, I don't even know why they bothered calling it something else. But yeah, I was right about, at the beginning of this, I was right about it being a darker episode after last week's episode being fun. They have the very clear pattern they're going by for that. So maybe let the season finale be a bit more fun, probably some pretty high stakes as well, though, and some big cliffhangers. But I'm interested to see, and I'm sad the show, this season's over, but we have season two to look forward to. Probably 2023, I'm going to guess, but just going to sit back and enjoy the last episode when it comes out next week. But until then, thanks for watching.